What is going on, my fellow fellas? It is your boy Illumity here, and today I am going to be doing a one box challenge on everyone's favorite challenge map, Bus Depot. Also, I don't have my jump bound from last video, so let me just redo that real quick. Where is it? There it is. If you didn't see that, it was a die rise, but I can't jump, so shameless plug, check it out if you want to. But yeah, today we're gonna be doing a one box challenge on possibly the hardest survival map. No perks, shitty training spots, yada yada yada. There's just everything's bad about this map. Nothing's good about it. The design sucks. This isn't a video about talking smack about Bus Depot. This is a challenge meant to test my absolute zombies gamer. This whatever gun we get is going to absolutely dictate the rest of the game. There's no grabbing double tap if we get like a bad gun or something like that. Also, the way I do my one box challenges, I'm sure this is how most people do it, but I don't allow wall weapons or anything like that. Maybe like the occasional galvanuckles or bowie knife, but I don't allow the purchasing of other wall weapons like guns. I don't know, it kind of defeats the purpose of the one box challenge. But I know I've had a couple friends who do theirs like that. So it's currently Thanksgiving today, but you know, your boy's gotta grind out a video. December is gonna be crazy. 12 days of zombies. I'm also sick right now. You can kind of hear it. I'm gonna be a bit more monotone than I already am. But yeah, hopefully we can get this challenge decent at least. I chose an extremely hard challenge specifically so that I need to remember that we don't have any lives. I chose a really hard challenge specifically for the fact that it won't be a super long video. But yeah, let's see. What are we going to get? Oh yeah, we're lasting till at least like round 100 million. I love the 5.7. No complaints about this. The 5.7 is absolutely the best gun in this game. Only superseded by the dual-wield 5.7, of course. But yeah, if you guys do end up enjoying this video, make sure to tell me what you guys want to see from me next, as I do a lot of challenges from viewers. This one is a recommendation from this guy, so thank you. Also, tell me... Oh, I missed the double points. But tell me what you guys want to see in streams, because I want to start streaming. Of course, I made a post saying that I won't be able to stream this week because I'm sick and busy. But yeah, let me know what you guys want to see for streams. Join the Discord if you want to talk to me or other people who like zombies. It's been really active there recently, actually, so thank you all for whoever's joined it. And finally, make sure to like and sub if you guys do end up enjoying this video. Share it with a fellow zombies enjoyer. And also, happy Thanksgiving, because this video is going to come out a day after Thanksgiving, but you know, I'm recording it on the day of Thanksgiving. So before I go out and enjoy any good food, gotta do this. And to any of you who aren't Americans, I won't say you're missing out, but you're kind of missing out. Getting together for a bunch of really good food and just eating and watching football, that's a peak holiday right there. And I don't even really like football. More of a basketball type of guy myself. Oh my gosh. This is why the 5.7 is just immaculate. I mean, it's a one tap to the head. Don't mind that it's round four, but like, yeah. I think the main issue that we're gonna have this playthrough or this challenge is just simply gonna be ammo, because one of the flaws the 5.7 actually has without glazing it is the ammo isn't too great. Damage is similar. Oh my fuck, yo. The damage is similar to an AR. I think the headshot multiplier is a bit higher, and then maybe the base damage is a bit lower. People don't realize that the 5.7 is literally just a pistol chambered in an AR bullet. It's great. I love the 5.7. Design, sound, everything about it. Every time I get the 5.7 in a video, I have to give it the ultimate fucking PowerPoint glazing slideshow. Oh, and I guess since this is the final video before December. I touched on it earlier, but if you guys are new to the channel, make sure to stick around. Stay tuned for December. I'm going to start a series called the 12 Days of Zombies, where every other day, starting on December 2nd, going until Christmas Eve, I'm going to release a zombies Christmas-themed video. So different things like custom maps, that's pretty much the main focus of it, but hopefully we'll get some like Christmas mods as well, or I'll take like a Christmas kind of themed challenge. I don't know who would be able to come up with one, but if you have an idea for it, let me know. But yeah, that starts in December, so if you guys like zombies and you also like Christmas and you're feeling quite jolly, make sure to stay tuned for that. Man, being sick sucks, especially if you're like talking into a mic for like around 20 to 40 minutes two times a week. It's hard to exhale and like put real emotion into my voice. Otherwise, you just get a sniffly fucking mess. I think the key to doing well in this challenge is get kills while the zombies are far away. Also, pick up any nukes and insta-kills whenever you have the opportunity, because usually you would like save it so you can get your points a bit higher, but we don't need points this time. We are literally not going to spend any more points this entire fucking game. Oh, and I guess since we're getting a bit later into the game, if we happen to run out of ammo, this is pretty much what I do with all my one box challenges. We'll spin a new gun from the box until, and we'll use that gun until we get ammo back. Oh yeah, but I did put on hellhounds, so this is kind of going to be a bit scary. But if we run out of ammo on our current gun, we will spin a new gun and use it until we get enough ammo, or until we get a max ammo on our actual gun. And then whenever we run out of ammo a second time, we'll spin a new gun so that we're not sticking with the same gun. Because we could get a really good gun like the Ray Gun Mark II and just absolutely abuse it by purposefully running out of ammo each time. Or we could get a really bad gun like the fucking S12 and just be cooked. So that's pretty much like all the rules that I set for these one box challenges. I mean, there's not really much to set aside from one box spin and what to do if we run out of ammo. It's hard to train with the 5.7, I'll say that much. Not because it's weak or like particularly bad for training. If anything, it's good because it has high mobility, but you need to make your headshots count, which is hard to do while ADSing, or while hip firing. ADSing is hard to do while training. It's, oh my gosh, it's all just like a giant loop of things that are hard to do. Oh yeah, another rule, the starting pistol is allowed, of course. You spawn in with the gun, so why wouldn't it be allowed? I kind of poorly explained the rules, but these are all rules that are pretty much very foreseeable, and I think most people play by these kinds of rules if they do one box challenges. I don't know, before I started YouTube, I didn't really do too many zombies challenges. Maybe the occasional two box challenge, but that's probably the most I ever did. So I will say this, along with YouTube being just fun in and of itself, it allowed me to explore a lot of different zombies challenges that I would have never done, like proning only on 5. Oh, yo. It also helped me get a lot fucking better at training. I can't see, dude. Oh my gosh. Okay, well, we're gonna run it back, of course, because this is just one of the maybe two or three runs that we're gonna do. But I don't know, whenever I play BO2, I feel like when I get blown up by a zombie, this is similar to like the fucking FaZe Rug clip. I feel like when I get blown up by a zombie, it's I get like a fucking concussion. Can't see at all whenever I get disoriented by the zombie's fire. It's fucking crazy. All right, back to round one. Unless we get a dual wield 5.7 or the 5.7, there's no way we're gonna beat that, because, you know, as we already explained, the 5.7 is literally just like the best weapon of all time. Oh, I guess since the this topic is relevant, what is everyone's favorite food for Thanksgiving? If I had to go for like main shit that you eat, I'd say maybe, well, I guess there's only like one main thing, which is turkey, but of like the sub main things, that doesn't really make sense. Kind of like an oxymoron, but of like the somewhat main things, I think my favorites are mac and cheese and stuffing for sure. And then in terms of desserts, it's cherry pie. Cherry pie is the best kind of pie. I don't care what anybody says. Even if you don't celebrate Thanksgiving, cherry pie is the best kind of pie. All right, I think we can go ahead and get our spin now, but we'll wait till the round is over just for the dramatic effect. Okay, sick. We got an insta-kill for next round. What are we gonna get? Hopefully not something too horrible. Oh my gosh. Now, when you think of horrible, you think of the SMR probably. That's like your first thought. When I think of horrible, think of the war machine. This is by far my least favorite weapon in BO2, and probably of all fucking COD history. Maybe the Springfield. Well, this run is not gonna last long at all. Man, they really just didn't do anything right with the war machine. The ricochet of the grenades is fucking insane. The fact the grenades don't blow up on impact is insane. The damage in general, even after the fucking grenade blows up, is kind of just bad. This gun just, there's not much good about the war machine. The only like decent thing about it is that when you pack a punch it, it actually turns into an impact grenade launcher, and then it's pretty decent. But the unfucking upgraded version, holy balls, You have no ammo, hardly any damage. Its fucking accuracy is literally horrible. Hey, maybe it'll be decent for training though. If I just like get a horde of like 10 to 24 zombies, shoot a couple bullets into the middle of it, then who knows? It'll be great. All I know is that if we do have ammo on our war machine when the dog round happens, we are not surviving. I'm gonna purposefully try and run out of ammo before the dog round. Good luck hitting a dog with a fucking war machine, dude. As I keep on using it, there's even more things that are just horrible about it. The mobility. All right, I'm gonna save up a full amount of stamina. All right, watch me sprint from like right here. Look how slow that is. Like, I had to weave through the zombies. I almost died. Maybe it'll shine here. Oh no, oh no. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Okay, I don't really want to pick up that max ammo, but we have to be genuine to the challenge, and oh man. I don't know which area is the best for training. This one is more restrictive, and it has the lava over there, but it's also, there's more space, and over there, it's just, there's just less space. Which one's the lesser evil? And honestly, I think there's a lot more things to bounce the war machine off of on this side, so we'll probably just stay over here. Oh my gosh. I tried. I really did. This war machine is just, it's two poopy buns. All right, well, usually I'd go for a third run because the video is kind of short, but it's Thanksgiving. I don't want to grind too much because, like I have already said, December is going to be fucking crazy. But wow, okay, I'm gonna keep this part in the video. Just if you guys did end up enjoying this video, make sure to like and sub. Join the Discord if you want to talk to me or other people who like zombies. Leave your video and stream ideas for me in the comments below. And yeah, stick around for the 12 days of zombies. Share this with somebody who likes zombies. Thank you all for watching, and as always, peace. Also, happy Thanksgiving. Peace.